to reset and restore this iMac G3. So this was recently donated to me by Sally. Thanks a lot. And I had to transfer some information to her phone with it. I was able to do that successfully, and I have to erase it, and because it's got some personal information on it that I don't want. And so also it's a bit dirty, so we're also going to be cleaning it up a bit. It's a bit dusty, but otherwise it's in pretty good condition. It did come with the original hockey puck mouse and keyboard that matched the computer. And I also have this, which I got from Mrs. M, and it's a bunch of iMac G3 software discs. And one of these is a software install disc. So what I'm probably going to do is reset the hard drive and install the software on it. And we're going to get to that. I have noticed one thing, however, is that there has not ever been a video on YouTube showing you how to actually reset one of these iMacs. So that's what I'm going to be doing in this video today. It's running macOS 9 and it works perfectly fine, and I'm excited. So let's get started. Take a closer look at this iMac. As you can see, the keys are quite dusty. There's not that much dirt, but as you can see, the dust is very clear to see, even on camera. The mouse is a different story. It's not as bad as you would think it is. The ball is relatively clean, but we're going to see what we can do about that. Otherwise, everything seems to be fine. The computer, however, is a bit better. There is a lot of dust in this handle over here, and it's not looking very clean either. But this is the newer model is pretty cool because you can see inside of it, but you can't really in this room because it's a bit dark. But I'm really excited to own one of these because I've been looking for an iMac DV for a while now, because the only iMac I do have is the G3, early 1999. This is late 1999. And this is one with the slot loading disk drive. And one thing I did notice is that the body shape of this newer model is slightly more different than the older one. For example, this bezel area is a little more curved. I did also notice that this area here, the line area, is a bit more, it's a bit more yellow. But I did see in a teardown video that underneath there is some beige plastic to give it color. I don't know if I'll be able to get in there, but we'll see. But I'm not even sure I'll be able to retrobrite it because it's quite big and I don't have a container this big. So let's get to the first up, we're going to start off with the keyboard because it's the most noticeably dirty. I always fill up a small container with rubbing alcohol and then I dip Q-tips in it and use them to clean the keyboard. It's best for getting into tight spaces like air vents, keyboard keys, and other miscellaneous things, sort of like that. For cleaning the actual computer, I usually use a paper towel with rubbing alcohol sprayed onto it, because I have a spray bottle over there, which I'll get out pretty soon. All I really do is just dip it in here and then just clean everything up. I'm not sure if this damages the keyboard or not, but it shouldn't, because these keyboards are pretty indestructible for keyboards. But you gotta really get in there. You gotta press down a bit. And then there you go. It's all clean. I usually use both sides. And once one side is very dirty, I switch to the other side. So, yeah. So we're gonna speed this up with a time lapse, and I'll be back with you once I'm done. And the keyboard is complete. It certainly looks a lot better than it did before. I can barely see any dust. There's a tiny bit of dust left, but I don't really want to pull off all the keys and also take too long. So I'm going to probably save that for another video. Now let's move on to the
hockey puck mouse.
One of the reasons that I'm so astonished that this came with this computer was because at the time people hated the hockey puck mouse because it was small and clumsy and it was weird to use in their hand because you'd always move around and people didn't really like it. So then eventually they replaced it with the Apple Pro mouse, which was more like a oval-shaped mouse, and it was a bit bigger, but it wasn't colored, and it went with a matching keyboard that also looked quite boring. I actually have a Pro keyboard right here. It is quite different. Compare it to the other keyboard. Well, one thing, however, is that the keys are the same, as you can see here, but the Pro keyboard has this extra area here with more function keys and other things like that, and as you can see on this keyboard, it has none of that. But I have a Pro mouse somewhere, but I can't seem to find it. But what I do know was that there was a black Pro mouse and a white Pro mouse, and yeah, it was pretty cool. In fact, I actually see it right now. Let me quickly. This is the Pro mouse. As you can see, they are quite different. This one doesn't have any features. It's just a click. It does have these two buttons on the side for functionality. But they are quite different. Also, the Pro mouse was Apple's first mouse that had Apple's first optical mouse, and also had a few different settings you can choose from here. I think it was sensitivity, I don't know what. But there was a black one, a blackish or like dark bluish one that was sort of see-through, and I thought that one was cool. I can't seem to find mine, but this is the closest I can get. This one, I do have to admit, it feels a lot nicer than this. I don't really have a problem with this because I don't really feel the clumsiness, but I do definitely prefer this mouse a lot more because I can feel this area here, and that's why I like it. But we're not focusing on this mouse. We're focusing on this other mouse, which is the hockey puck mouse. So basically, the way to take out the ball, all you have to do is just twist this. Everything like this comes off. And there you have it. You have this cool multicolored ball that looks really cool in the mouse when you move it around. As you can see here, you can sort of see it. And it looks really cool. I thought that was a cool design feature. But anyway, what we're just going to do is we're just going to get a paper towel, spray it with a little alcohol, and we're going to get the ball, and we're just going to rub it on the paper towel. You can already see some of the grime coming off. The reason that this is probably the dirtiest part of every computer, because the ball goes everywhere where the mouse goes, and who knows how dirty someone's desk could be. I mean, yeah, but it's actually not as dirty as I thought, but it is looking a lot better. Some of the earlier Apple mice that had balls, some of these balls were made out of metal, but they had like a rubber casing on them, which I thought was very interesting to hear. But I have some of the newer models. This does feel quite heavy for rubber. This might be one of those mice that have the metal in them, but who knows. I'm also going to take this time to clean some of the reed heads, I guess. Because basically in the mouse, they have these, there are two types of ball mount mice. They're the ball mice with the wheels, like this one, that turn. And they're also the ones that have lasers that sense where the ball is going. This one is an older one with a wheel, as you can see here. But I'm going to clean them anyway, just to give them a little, just so that they are a bit nicer. Otherwise, I can't seem to see any other issues with this mouse. So I guess we're just gonna put it back together. I might do some more outside cleaning. I might do some more exterior cleaning right now. So we're gonna do that. The cable's also really nice. Usually the cables have like these black marks on them. But this one doesn't. This one's a pretty nice for an old Apple cable. Gonna clean up these rubber areas here. It's really nice like this. Some dust stuck to it. Clean that all up, and there you go. Voila! Mouse all clean. In fact, it looks almost These areas over here look almost transparent now, now that they're clean, which is pretty cool. But it's nice to see this mouse looking nice. So now that we've done the keyboard and the mouse, time to move on to the main attraction itself.
Quite familiar with iMac G3s. In fact, the iMac G3 was actually probably one of the first ever Apple computers I've got in my collection, I've ever received in my collection. I don't know, it's either my iBook G3 or my iMac G3. I think the iMac G3 was the first ever old Apple computer that I've received. I'm talking about the G3 Snow, not the clamshell. The clamshell I got not even a year ago. Maybe, I don't know. Might have been in December of 2017, who knows, but one of the most noticeable areas with grime and dirt and dust is the handle, so we're gonna clean that up. I'm also gonna clean up some of these scuffs, so yeah, I'm gonna time-lapse this because you're probably getting bored, so be back in a sec. Yeah, that was quicker than expected. I'm not gonna clean the screen, though, because I ran out of electronic wipes, and when I went to CVS earlier, I couldn't find any. I'm not sure, I don't remember where I bought them. It could have been the hardware store or the supermarket, but I'll have to see soon. But for now, the screen is looking pretty clean how it is, and I don't really want to make it look all nasty and streaky for the video, but otherwise this computer is looking very nice, a lot better than before. Not that noticeably though, because this has been taken very well care of, and I'm happy to see that. So now that we have finished the restoration, it is time to do the software, to reset it and install the new Mac OS on it. So yeah.
So now that we have the iMac all set up and ready to go, we're going to get to the procedure of resetting the iMac's hard drive. So that orange pouch I told you about came with these two discs, a software install disc and a software restore disc for the iMac DV models, which is this iMac right here. I believe this is Mac OS 9.0.3, but this computer is running Mac OS 9, so I guess this is kind of going to be an upgrade. So basically what you got to do, so I'm going to do the software install disk because that one seems more promising. So what you're going to do is you're going to get your disk out. Make sure you don't put any fingerprints on it because it's nice to keep your disks clean. So basically, what you're going to do is you're going to start up your iMac, you're going to put the CD in, and press down on the C key as it's starting up. And then it will start, and then it will boot into the CD OS, and then you will be able to have access to all the hard drives and everything that are connected to this iMac. So we're going to do that right now. So, we're going to turn it on. Take the CD, press down the C key. Starting up. Yes, I believe it is starting into the CD OS because I hear the CD drive going. The background of the CD OS should be a bunch of pictures of CDs, but if this doesn't work, then we can try again but this should work because I hear the CD going. I don't hear the hard drive, however. Well, I think I do. I'm not sure if that's the hard drive or not. It might be the CRT or some of the components on the analog board. And there you go. There's the CD OS. So, basically, once you see this, you don't have to press the C key anymore. But as you can see in the background, it's a bunch of pictures of CDs with a CD logo on it. But, yeah, you're just going to wait for this to start up, and then it will take you to this utilities area. And that's what you will be doing. So, I'm going to cut to when that happens, so I'll see you in a bit. We are here. So this is a bit different than I thought. I have already done this, however. So basically, instead of the hard drive icon, which is down here by the trash can, you have this CD icon, the iMac install CD. You also have all the information from your hard drive. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into the install CD. You go in here. Haven't actually done this before. Okay, so I think you oh, here it is, macOS install. I was looking for that, but I didn't see it there. But yeah, it's going to take you to this. It's like, this is what would happen if you're installing macOS. So, this is the welcome to the macOS 9 installation program. This program will guide you through the four steps necessary to install macOS 9. It's like the destination disk, read important information, respond to the software license agreement, and install software. But yeah, if you don't have any of these disks, you can buy them on eBay for like $12. It does sound like a lot of money, but if you are selling one of these and you don't want your information on it in someone else's hands, then I do recommend getting one of these. So we're going to do the destination disk Macintosh hard drive. We're going to select that. Okay, nobody cares. It's just, okay, license agreement. Nobody reads this because who cares? All right, click start. This should erase everything on the hard drive, by the way. And if it doesn't, then I must have been doing something wrong. But I'm not too much of an expert on it, but I believe I know what I'm doing. This should be the right thing to do anyway. So we're going to wait for this. So this is going to take about 14 minutes. I'm going to pause the video and then resume once we're done with this. So I'll see you in a bit. Well, this is awfully boring. Almost there. I never mentioned that the hard drive on an iMac sounds like popcorn popping in a microwave. I never really realized that until now. Finally, it's done. Okay, so now that the installation process has finished, I think that's it. Did it erase it, or did it just install a newer operating system? Who knows? It should have already, done it. I wonder what this is, iMac late breaking news. This is a vintage, who cares, it's boring. Alright, so we're gonna restart the computer without the disk in it. So yeah, let's see what happens. Okay, I was expecting it to eject the disk, but who knows. Okay. So, it's starting up. Who knows what will happen. This should be, this should work. When I boot this up, it should have no information on it. And if it does, then I've done something wrong. I'm not sure what I've done wrong or how to do this. I just believe that that should be the way. And if it isn't, then I've done something awfully wrong. I don't think I did it right, because that's the original background of the user settings. Oh, shoot. I don't think I did this right. Let's just see if there's any information on it. And if there isn't, or if it just tells me to welcome to macOS, then I might have done it right. Who knows? Let's see. Let's see if it gives us the little window that says welcome to macOS that allows us to erase this. Because that's one thing that it could do. Or there's just not any information. So it does seem to have all the files on it, which is not good. Okay, this is what I was expecting to come up. I was hoping this would come up. But yeah, let's just see first, because I'm not sure I did this right. Okay, so we live in United States. Don't have an organization. No, we are not. The time is 11/22/22 Yes, that is correct. Today's date is the 6th of the 23rd. It is 2018. Anyway, so now that we have that done, that's not where I live. You know what? I'm gonna fill this out because this is getting a bit too personal. So I'm gonna quickly fill this out and we're gonna see what happens.
I finished everything.
It asked me if I wanted to connect to the internet and I said no. I'm not gonna be using this computer for that type of stuff. I might buy another iMac DV just to do internet sort of stuff, but I think I did this wrong. Unless I just press this again, because what's supposed to happen is it's supposed to ask me if I want to erase the disk. I think I may have done something wrong, however. Yeah. Reinstall. Okay, so I guess here, I want the disk to be erased and then have a fresh install of macOS on it. And I already have some CDs that have all these cool programs, so it doesn't really matter what programs are on this. Add/remove, I believe. No, that's not it. Select, reinstall. Continue, agree. Options. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, and now we're back to this thing again. I'm gonna be bored. While this happens, I'm gonna see if I've done anything wrong, and I'm gonna see if I've been doing this right. So yeah, I'll be back.
So
it turns out I have been doing this all wrong. So I'm gonna cancel this because this is not what I'm supposed to be doing. Basically, what I'm doing is installing a new software on it, but not actually erasing the hard drive. So I'm doing this all wrong. So stop installation. So I've been doing it right with holding down the C key and going into the disk operating system thing. So I'm going to quit. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to boot into the disk thing. So, restart, hold down the C key, and do that again. Holding down the C key, and then it's gonna boot up into the disk utility thing, so I'll be back.
So I found out how it works. So, it's a little different from the things on the newer hard drive. Operating system. So, what you gotta do is you gotta press this. You have all this trash that we're gonna remove. So you go to special, erase disk. And we're gonna completely erase the disk named Macintosh hard drive. So this is gonna delete everything on it, even the operating system. But then we're gonna reinstall it by doing a different process.
So, I think we're going to be doing the macOS standard, because I don't want to... You know what, I'll do extended. Alright, so it's erasing. I think it's done. Is it done? That was way too quick. I think it's done. Yeah, everything is gone. So now all we have to do is install macOS onto this thing. Because now that everything is gone, we're gonna need to install it. So continue. Select this. A lot of space on it, because everything's gone. Continue, nobody cares. But yeah, so, anyway, so now it's gonna be installing the OS onto it, and, yeah, so I'll see you when it's done. Before we install the OS, I just realized there is this customized tab, and here you can deselect all the things you will not need at all. For example, I'm not going to be needing any printer applications or any other things that aren't useful. But usually on a newer computer, there are a lot more things to deselect, but I guess I don't need text. I'm pretty sure I don't need text to speech, but I'm gonna keep it all selected here because I don't think these types of things take up that much space. Yeah, so actually stop installation. Anyway, so I'm actually gonna do don't customize, and we're just gonna start this, and it's just gonna do this all over again. So yeah, I'll be back in a sec. I need one of those.
So now that the installation is complete,
now we should be able to restart the computer and hope for the best. So what should happen I'm gonna restart the computer, and what should happen is that there should be just a regular macOS background, not that purple lollipop background that I'm probably gonna change back anyway because it looks nice with the computer. But it should also have this welcome screen where you can set up the computer. And if I'm lucky, there's gonna be a cool vintage welcome to macOS video. But let's see. So, restarting. Starting up. This should be a clean install of macOS 9. Not pressing any keys. The CD is in there, however. I erased the hard drive. Starting up. Okay, this is different. Spent the last 20 minutes watching YouTube videos about urine-colored iMacs. Okay, this looks promising. I guess this is the default background of macOS 9? Oh. Okay. Never seen this before. It seems to be a background of some sort. Okay, so this is what I was expecting. I'm not such a big fan of the background, but it does seem to be working. Okay, and more of these questions. I'm going to stop the video because this is getting personal, and I'll be right back.
You're done with the personal information.
So we're going to go ahead. Setting computer name, location, all the other things. MacOS setup assistant is done. I do not want to set up this thing up for the internet. Again, I'm just going to be using this for more modern software versions, and I'm not really going to be using it for web browsing. If I were going to use a computer like this for web browsing, I would buy a completely different system to do this. And also, I don't have the right airport card to be able to do this, and I don't feel like getting out a modem. So yeah, it seems to be done. I'm going to, let's actually see if there's anything on the hard drive. Okay, there doesn't seem to be anything. Yeah, there's nothing. System folder, let's see if it comes with any interesting applications. Hoping it would come with NanoSaur or something interesting like that. Is there like a applications folder? Huh. ROM, CD-ROM, login, internet services, control script manager. Eh, I don't know. I'm probably just gonna make a whole video on this anyway, and probably demonstrate some things. But what we're now gonna do is eject this macOS install CD. So all you gotta do is drag it into the trash can, then it should eject. Has a bit of trouble objecting, but oh crud. But we're done. So now that the this iMac is done with the installation, I just want to quickly personalize this quickly. Let's see. Monitor setting. It's a bit different from the monitor settings on the older computer. General controls. Energy saver. Appearance. Here we are. It was at the top the whole time. I'm not going to do Great Mission. I don't really like that one. I'm going to do Lollipop 2 because my other computer has like a lollipop themed background. And yeah, I want them to match. And there we have it. The Grape iMac is ready to go. So now that we have completed this software installation and this video, it is time to do the outro and end this video. So that'll do it for today's video. I'm sorry it took so long to get to the resetting the software. I wasn't anticipating it to take this long. I originally intended it because I thought I knew how to do it, but then I realized I was doing some things wrong. But eventually I was able to do it. So I hope this video could help you Mac users out there who are willing to get rid of something like this. But if you do have something like this that you're willing to get rid of, donate to my YouTube channel, link in the description below. If you have one of these that you want, don't know what to do with and you want to erase, you can erase it with this video guide, or I can erase it for you and then you can give it to me for my collection, because I am starting to collect all the iMac colors, but I'm only at blueberry and grape, but I want to see how far I can go. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and a review and demo of this computer is coming very soon. Probably going to be my next video, but who knows. So yeah, I'm going to base a whole video on this computer, just like I do with all my other computers. I've even done a review and demo on this computer. So yeah, so that'll do it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe, comment down below what you want me to do next, and also subscribe for the 100 sub special, which is coming soon. There is a chance it might not happen because of some technical difficulties, but we'll just have to see. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.